Hello, I'm Ashoka Veerakaran from NARA. Today I'm going to talk about the current status of microplastic pollution in the ocean around Sri Lanka. As you know, plastic and polythene has become a major marine litter today, and it is a global issue that we should address at our earliest. Plastic and polythene can be categorized based on its shape, physical size, origin, and the polymer composition. When it comes to microplastics, they are the particles that are smaller than 5 millimeters in size. We think microplastics are dangerous because they are buoyant. They can be taken from place to place by ocean currents, winds, and they can carry different toxic components and can be toxic to marine biota and can be bioaccumulated in food chains. So we started this study in 2016. First, we wanted to study the abundance. We wanted to see the pollution levels in Sri Lanka. Then we wanted to study the spatial variations and the potential sources of pollution, of microplastic pollution in Sri Lanka. Then in a future stage, we wanted to study the impacts on microplastics in ecosystem components, animals, and human beings. So we study microplastics in the surface layer in the ocean around Sri Lanka in six different regions. So we collected samples using a manta troll net having a mesh size of 300 micrometers. And then we cleaned the samples, observed the samples under a dissecting microscope, collected the samples, preserved them, and conducted a FTIR test for further chemical assessment. So you can see the results, the graphs given in the screen. So we found that the nearshore waters are more polluted compared to offshore waters. It means that the coastal waters are more polluted. Also, we found that the west coast is very polluted compared to the east coast. The overall average abundance of microplastics was 0.31. particles per cubic meter. And the average physical size was 1.18 millimeters. So we found different physical and chemical properties of microplastic particles. And we found that there are different weathering patterns as well. So in conclusion, the major sources of pollution are the industries related to packaging material, fisheries, and textiles. The major microplastic particles belong to the secondary category. And most were polypropylene, polyethylene, polystyrene, nylon, PET, like plastics with low densities. We found that plastic contained different toxic material components that can be very toxic to human and animals. And our suggestions are to conduct studies on the effect of microplastics on different ecosystem components, fish, seafood, animal tissues, and if possible, human tissues as well, because smaller plastic particles can be ingested by marine biota and it can be in the human food and can be in human tissues as well. So we need to address this as well. Thank you very much.